Cuentos del abuelito. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. On this occasion, I'll narrate the story of El Silbón, a very, very popular folklore from Venezuela. If you like the story, feel free to like, comment, and share it. Also, I want to mention that I know I haven't been too busy uploading stories, but I've been busy outside of all of this, real busy with work. But I'll try to get more active around February, maybe around March. So just be patient, and thank you to all the ones who've stuck around. Anyway, with all that being said, let's get to it. El Silbón, or the man who whistles, is a scary legend from Venezuela about a young boy who murdered his parents and is doomed to carry a sack of bones on his back for all eternity. They say he eats people, especially children, drunks, and unfaithful men. El Silbón, or the man who whistles, is a frightening figure who appears at night in rural areas. He is a tall, skinny man with a deformed face who carries a bag of bones on his back. El Silbón is famous for the eerie tune he whistles, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti. They say it can make the hair stand up on the back of your neck and the blood freeze in your veins. If his whistling sounds very loud, it means he is far away. If the whistling sounds very faint, it means El Silbón is nearby and you should immediately flee the area. Years ago, there was a young boy who lived with his mother, father, and grandfather in Los Llanos, Venezuela. They lived a very simple life, tending to their farm. However, the boy was pampered by his parents and they raised a very spoiled child. He was extremely demanding, ordering his parents around and refusing to eat certain foods. The boy had no respect for anyone. He would make a big fuss, shouting and screaming until he got his way. His poor parents were worn out trying to please him. One day the boy told his father he wanted to eat his favorite meat, deer meat. His father was desperate to please his spoiled son, so he went out hunting. After hours of searching through the forest, the exhausted man returned empty-handed, hanging his head in shame. The young boy flew into rage, and taking his own dad's hunting knife, he plunged it into his father's chest again and again. Then he ripped open his father's belly and pulled out his guts. The boy carried his father's guts back to the house. He gave them to his mother and asked her to cook them. The mother became suspicious. Where did you get these guts from? I got them from my father, the boy casually replied. And where did your father get them from? Asked the mother. He grew them in his belly, said the boy. The mother couldn't believe what she was hearing. She rushed out to the forest and searched frantically for her husband. She found his corpse next to a bush. He had been cut open and there was blood everywhere. The horrified woman fell to her knees and began screaming and howling in grief. When the boy's grandfather heard what he had done, he was full of fury and couldn't contain himself. The old man took it upon himself to punish the boy for his terrible sins. First, he tied the murderous child to a tree and beat him over and over with a whip until his back was raw and bloody. Then he rubbed lemon juice and hot peppers into his wounds to make them sting. Finally, he handed the boy an old sack containing his father's bloody remains and threw him out to the plains. As the boy fled, his grandfather shouted after him, "You should not have done that to your father. On your head I lay a curse. You will be damned for all eternity." With that, he set his dogs on the boy, and they chased him down, nipping and biting at his heels. Eventually, the dogs caught up with the boy and killed him. The curse transformed into El Silbón, an undead spirit who must roam the world eternally, followed by a spectral dog that constantly chases him. He is doomed to wander the plains, carrying the bones of his victims on his back and bringing death and destruction to anyone he comes across. At night, El Silbón enters people's homes and lays a sack of bones on the floor. He starts counting the bones, and if no one in the house hears him, it means that someone in the house will die before sunrise. If the family is awakened by his counting, then everyone in the house will experience good luck. El Silbón is more active during the rainy season, so you should use extreme caution during this time of the year.